What is up, guys? Galo here. This is going to be something, I guess, quite new on the tubes. At least I wasn't able to find too many examples of such videos. Well, today we're going to propose an answer to a question that most of Yu-Gi-Oh! Fans were asking themselves. And that is, what would happen if Yugi had lost to Kaiba? This is quite a tricky question. Which duel are we talking about? Well, those two faced each other 3 times, at least in the anime. At the beginning of the series, where Yugi won with Exodia, in Duelist Kingdom, where Kaiba won because suicide, and in Battle City, where Yugi pulled out Dark Paladin out of his buttocks. To be perfectly honest, I think the most logical point for such an event is the duel in Battle City. Before we start, I would like to inform you that all cards used in this scenario were canonically used by the characters in the Battle City arc. So, without further ado, let's get into it. Let's start the story when Kaiba activates his final attack orders. All the monsters on the field are switched to attack position, and both players have to pick 3 cards from their decks and continue with only those. Kaiba, well, being himself, chooses his Blue Eyes, a combination of Lord of D and the Flute of Summoning Dragon. Of course, with combination with his most prized monsters, should be enough to take Yugi down. Yugi thinks for a moment, well, the most obvious answer is that Kaiba is going to use his Blue Eyes. So Yugi starts taking cards from his deck. He starts picking the ones he did in the anime, the cards that would help him counter Kaiba's Blue Eyes. Then a thought hits him. What if Kaiba is going to bring back Obelisk? Or even Slifer? Well, that's not something he wouldn't do. He always wanted to beat Yugi, and if he could do it with Yugi's monster, the victory would be even sweeter. Yugi is lost for a moment, doesn't know which option to choose, as both seem very Kaiba-esque. Being lost in thought for a few minutes passes, Yugi still hasn't chosen his cards, and Kaiba is getting visibly angry. Yugi finally snaps out of it and bets on the second option, thinking Kaiba would let his ego dictate his play. That's why he chooses premature burial and necromancy as his counter strategy. Unfortunately, Yugi failed. His overthinking made him blind to the most obvious answer. Kaiba's Blue Eyes quickly dealt with both Red-Eyed Black Dragon and the Dark Magician. Yugi was beaten, his god card lost, he fell on his knees in disbelief. Kaiba started laughing. Now all that's left is to take his prize. Slifer, the Sky Dragon. Seto slowly walks towards his opponent. He savors this moment of glory. He takes Slifer out of Yugi's deck, gets a triumphant smug on his face. He knows that Yugi now has to catch up to him. Now he is the best. Not that he ever thought otherwise, but now he has the win to prove it. With that retort, Kaiba leaves the dueling arena. With that retort, Kaiba leaves the dueling arena and goes to his quarters in order to get ready for his final duel. He still has 1 god card to obtain, and he knows this isn't going to be easy. Merrick was watching the duel and is astonished. He was supposed to defeat the Pharaoh. His dream, his revenge, was stolen. And by Kaiba, of all people. No. This cannot stand. In Merrick's mind, killing Seto would be the most suiting punishment for this crime. But wait a moment, that would be too easy. He has to suffer and have his dream taken away. Yes, that would be much more appropriate. Eye for an eye, as they say. The day of the finals arrive. Both participants are ready to duel. Merrick is going to start, and he goes first. Kaiba looks at his opponent as he was just a pebble on his road to glory. A big one, but still a pebble. This makes Merrick angrier. No, he doesn't want to make Kaiba just suffer. He wants him to scream for mercy. No one looks at the mighty Merrick Ishtar like that. And those that do, die. The duel is about to start. The entire arena is enveloped in a veil of darkness. This is now a shadow game. The rules are simple. The person closest to each of the duelists will be chained, and their life directly linked to the duelist's life points. Once the life points reach zero, the person chain will cease to exist. On the yummy Merrick's side, the person chain is obviously the good Merrick, like in the anime, since, well, you cannot be closer to anyone but yourself. On Kaiba's side, the chained person is Mokuba, his little brother, because he is Kaiba's everything. Merrick draws a vampiric leech and normal summons it in attack position. Then he activates its effect, dealing Kaiba 500 points of damage. After which, Merrick discards his winged dragon of Ra in order to use vampiric leech's other effect and switch to defense position. He then ends his turn by setting a card. Mokuba starts screaming in pain when his left hand is disappearing, begging his brother to help him. Kaiba isn't fazed by it, and it only makes Merrick laugh maniacally. Now it's Kaiba's turn, so he draws. He then activates his thunder dragon in his hand, adding two more copies from his deck. He then plays polymerization, fusing both of them into his twin-headed thunder dragon. Afterwards, Kaiba activates his spell card, Soul Exchange, targeting Merrick's Vampiric Leech. After the effect resolves, Kaiba tributes Vampiric Leech and Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon, which counts as two tributes in accordance to the tournament rules, and summons his Obelisk the Tormentor. Merrick subsequently activates his face-down card, Metal Reflect Slime, summoning a slime token to his side of the field in defense position, defending him from Kaiba's assault. Seto enters his battle phase and destroys the slime token with Obelisk's attack. Afterwards, he sets two cards and ends his turn. Kaiba is gloating at his first turn. He knows that he has this duel in the bag. With the might of Obelisk, there is nothing Merrick can do to stop him. Now it's Merrick's turn, so he draws. He summons Plasma Eel in defense position. Subsequently, he activates his machine duplication, which allows him to summon two more copies of Plasma Eel in defense mode. He ends his turn by setting two cards face down. Kaiba is mocking Merrick's weak turn. This isn't a challenge. Obelisk will just get rid of those. Is he even trying? Merrick says nothing. He just smiles. Now it's Kaiba's turn. So he draws. He activates his face down card, Stop Defense, targeting one of Merrick's plasma eels, switching into attack position. He then proceeds to attack that monster with his obelisk. And due to Obelisk's status as a god card, Merrick cannot do anything to stop the damage. After the damage calculation, Merrick Ishtar starts disappearing, only his face remaining. Afterwards, Kaiba proceeds to activate the card that he drew this turn, his card of demise, letting him draw five more cards. He summons Y Dragonhead in defense mode and sets two cards face down. After that, he ends his turn. Kaiba is still full of himself. Merrick is resisting, but there is nothing he can do to stop Obelisk. Merrick thinks nothing of it. He just chuckles and starts his turn. Merrick draws. He sets one card face down and activates the card in his hand, his Cards of Sanctity. Now both he and Kaiba will draw until they have six cards, Merrick drawing six and Kaiba drawing four. Kaiba activates one of his face down, Thirst for Compensation, summoning two level 4 monsters from his hand, his X-Head Cannon and the Z-Metal Tank, both in attack position. Merrick switches all of his monsters to defense, sets three cards face down, and ends his turn. Merrick taunts Seto, expecting gratitude for this little gift he gave him, since Kaiba will need all the help he can get. Seto doesn't need any help and he knows it. He's the best and he's going to prove it right here, right now. Kaiba draws. Merrick activates his face-down card, Coffin Seller, in response to that. Seto then proceeds to summon his XYZ Dragon Cannon, and subsequently activates the monster's effect, discarding his Dark Gremlin to destroy Machine Duplication. By the effect of Machine Duplication, two Plasma Eels summoned by this card are destroyed, leaving Merrick with only one weak monster. Kaiba then tributes his XYZ Dragon Cannon to summon his second god card, Slifer the Sky Dragon. Kaiba gloats even more. Now he has two gods on the field and Merrick has none. There is nothing he can do to stop him. It's only a matter of time before Seto gets his hands on Ra. Merrick smirks and starts his turn. Merc draws. He then tributes Slifer and Obelisk in order to summon his lava golem to Kaiba's side. Afterwards, he sets one card face down and ends his turn. Kaiba is shocked. Both Egyptian gods gone just like that? Merc taunts Seto, and that makes the young billionaire angry. At this point, Merc knows he's got him now. Kaiba draws. During his standby phase, Lava Golem's effect activates, dealing him 700 points of damage. Kaiba tributes Lava Golem to summon Kaiser Glider in attack position. Merc anticipated that and activates his phase down card, Joyful Doom, changing Kaiser Glider's attack to zero and recovering 2400 life points. With him recovering life points, Merc Ishtar gets back his torso, his right hand and his left leg. Kaiba then sets two cards face down and ends his turn. Merc congratulates Kaiba for dealing with his lava golem. Seto takes none of it, but he's letting his anger cloud his judgment. Merc draws. He then proceeds to normal summon Drilago and attacks Kaiser Glider with that monster. Kaiba activates his magic trick mirror in response, targeting Merc's card of sanctity, then chains Ring of Destruction, targeting Drilago, and Ring of Defense. With that combination, he destroys Merc monster, deals effect damage to his opponent, and replenishes his hand. Merc taunts Seto. He knows that he has already won the duel, so why not have a bit more fun? He then proceeds to set one card face down and ends his turn. Kaiba draws a card. He then activates Monster Reborn from his hand, summoning back his XYZ Dragon Cannon. Afterwards, Merc activates his face down card, Zombie's Jewel. And by the card's effect, he adds to his hand Kaiba's Monster Reborn, and Kaiba draws a card. Seto then proceeds to use XYZ Dragon Cannon's effect. He discards Quick Attack, Lullaby of Obedience, and Sagi the Dark Clown to destroy Merc Plasma Eel, Coffin Cellar, and one of his face downs, which turns out to be Malevolent Catastrophe. Seto then normal summons Lord of Dragons. Afterwards, Merc activates his Hidden Soldier's Trap, allowing him to summon Makura the Destructor in defense position. Kaiba plays Flute of Summoning Dragon and summons two Blue Eyes White Dragons to the field. He then destroys Makura with one of his blue eyes, and now he starts laughing. Merc has no monsters, he has a Blue Eyes White Dragon ready to attack. So, he ends the duel with his blue eyes. But Merc has none of it. He activates Makura's effect, which allows him to play a trap card from his hand. And he activates Mirror Force, destroying all monsters Kaiba controls. Seto sets a card face down, activates his power balance, making Merc discard Revival Gem and Gem Defender, after which Kaiba draws two more cards. He then activates Silent Doom, summoning Sagi back to the field in defense position. He sets a card face down and ends his turn. Seto is agitated. He almost had it. He was already there. He could taste the victory. But Merc isn't allowing him to. He isn't going down. And that makes him angrier. As for Merc, he's loving it. Every single second of it. That's what you get for beating the Pharaoh. Merc draws a card. He then proceeds to summon Holding Legs in attack position. And when he does, the monster's effect activates, returning all set spells and traps to the owner's hand. Afterwards, he activates two copies of Monster Reborn. One of his, and the one he got from Kaiba, summoning back his winged dragon of Ra from his graveyard, and Kaiba's blue eyes white dragon. Merc activates Ra Phoenix mode, destroying Kaiba's last line of defense, after which he attacks Seto directly with his own blue eyes white dragon, humiliating his opponent even more, and winning the duel. Due to the nature of the shadow game, Mokuba's soul vanishes, leaving his body an empty husk. Kaiba reluctantly gives Merc his Slifer the Sky Dragon and starts to storm off the duel arena. Seto then tells Roland to get the chopper ready. They're leaving the island and blowing it sky high. That's the moment when he gets the most horrific news he could imagine. His little brother was in a coma. He suddenly fell on the ground when the duel started and hasn't been responsive ever since. Kaiba turns pale. He turns around and looks at Merc. Merc is just smiling and laughing. That can't be right. Magic isn't real. That duel couldn't have affected Mokuba. Kaiba breaks down and starts yelling. Marek is laughing maniacally. He knows that Kaiba finally realized what happened. Tears start to appear in Kaiba's eyes, but he knows he cannot let himself go. He tells Roland just to keep moving with the plan. Everybody can see that at that point, Kaiba died inside. After getting Slifer and breaking Kaiba's spirit, the only thing that Marek has to do is gather his rare hunters and use the power he has to take over, becoming the Pharaoh of Earth is in his grasp, and there's no one who can stop him. He leaves the duel arena, still laughing. Well, and that'll be it. Wow, I know I wrote this and then I recorded it, but still, Marek, that was cruel. Not out of character though, you sick psychopath. Well, I hope YouTube won't flag this video due to Mokuba's new circumstances. And Seto, oh, poor guy. Well, he still has his obelisk though. Maybe he'll play a role in later installment. Anyway, if you like this, leave a comment or a like, preferably both. I also wonder, how did you find this scenario? Do you think something should be different? I'm eager to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. Anyway, see y'all all next time.